back to our e-telecast, God Has a Word for You, and I'm Pastor Aminata. Well, have the subject on faith. I believe God that is going to help somebody. Lord knows it's helping me, and I'm excited. I just must be crazy, because I get excited about getting into God's Word and love how He peels back the information and reveals such awesome thing that most time is right in front of our faces if we would just study to show ourselves approved to who? To God. Not to the pastor and not to the preacher, not to the evangelist, but to show ourselves approved to God. A workman who don't have to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. Well, let's get back to our subject, faith walker. Or a fake talker. People who have faith and they demonstrate their faith not by what they say but by what they do. Or fake talkers, people who act like they have faith, who always want to talk like they have faith, but let a crisis hit. Let drama come and visit them. You'll find out who's full of faith and who isn't. Let's go back to the Word of God. We was in Hebrews, the 11th chapter. And we talked about the last time and looked at how even though the word faith itself only appears two times in the Old Testament, but yet it gives us just a whole bundle of witnesses from Abraham to Enoch to Abel to Sarah to a few others who what? Believe God. And then we came to understand that the definition of faith is belief and trust. Look at this. Let's go to Hebrews 11 and 6. I believe it's 6. Hebrews 11 and 6 says, But without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. For without faith, it is impossible to please God. And isn't that what we want to do? We want to please God. Not unless you're stuck on stupid, because if you're stuck on stupid, you ain't thinking about pleasing God. You're only thinking about self. And then that just begs the question, and we're right back where we started. But if you really want to please God, then this is how we do it, and that is by using our faith. Faith meaning I trust you, God, and I believe you, God. Now listen, it took faith to get us saved, and that means if it takes faith to get us saved, it's going to take faith to keep us saved. And if God can save us, then can He help us? Can He come through for us no matter what the situation is? Because how can we believe God for this and not believe Him for that? How can we believe God for the gift of eternal life and not believe that He can help pay a bill? How can we believe God for that we will be able to reign forevermore with Jesus, with Him in the heavenly places, and we can't believe that He will help deliver our children? How can we believe that God is the God who made the heavens and the earth, and we can't believe that He can heal us? How can we believe Him for this and not believe Him for that? For it says, for without faith we can't please Him. You want to piss God off? Unbelief will do it every time. You want to make Him angry? Unbelief will do it every time. It's like saying, it's like, oh, I trust you today, but I can't trust Him for this. He can't do that. Come on. God is not like us. He ain't fickle. And we don't want, thank God, He's not like us. And we want to strive to be like Him. He's consistent. He is the all-present, all-powerful, almighty God. What is it that He can't do? And that's what you must internalize spiritually, so that when your trauma and drama come knocking on your door, you can say, what? All things are possible. And I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Come on. You got to learn how to speak to your situation. Faith demands that you do so. Faith demands that you look it right in the eye and say, come with it. It doesn't matter what you say. Come with it. Ah, that's the other key. See, because the eyes. If we're not in the Word and we're not developing our relationship with God, we are left to what? Our eyes. We are left to what we see every day. We are left to what's going on around us every day, and it will consume you. Remember now, Noah, by faith, he got a divine revelation of things that wasn't even seen yet, and he moved on it. But we're so busy operating on what we see, and that's enough to really upset God. And when I come back, I'm going to show you what happened to a few people when they pissed them off. God don't like unbelief, believe it or not. I'm Pastor Aminata. Until the next time, God has a word for you.
If you haven't yet accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, let's do so right now with this prayer of salvation. Pray after me, but it's more important that you believe it in your heart. Father God, I believe your word, and your word says that if I confess with my mouth the Lord Jesus and believe in my heart that God has raised him from the dead, that I will be saved. So right now I put my trust in you, Jesus Christ, as my personal Lord and Savior. I admit that I'm a sinner and that I need God in my life. So I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. Amen. So if you prayed that prayer, I want you to drop us a line and email us. And let us know, because right now, you are saved and the angels in heaven are rejoicing. And do yourself a huge favor and find yourself a Bible-believing church and continue to grow in grace. God bless you.